All right, so let's look into the GPT-4 Browse with Bing beta. I'm sure you were all excited, just like I was, when you got access to this feature that would give ChatGPT access to the web, promising more than the live crawl feature that we have in AIPRM for a month anyways. With live crawling, you would fetch one specific URL specifically for analysis. A lot of SEOs use that, but now we have the promise that ChatGPT can browse the web for us and become more accurate. And what's a better test than AIPRM, which launched in January 2023? And I'm not impressed. What it says here after finished browsing is that AIPRM stands for AI Risk Management. I don't even know how that would work. And that it's a tool for managing risks associated with AI. You can tell it has some fever temperature here and starts to hallucinate, or at least it looks like that. And it refers to one source, pcguide.com. But using AIPRM, minimize potential risks, the same source. When you open this here, you have the same what is this effect that I have. It just searched for AIPRM and clicked on one result. And this pcguide.com is some totally spammy AI content affiliate cookie cutter site that is certainly not a reputable source. And especially when we talk about browsing the web for information, it just looked at one result. So what's that about? Are you being serious here? I've done some tests, I've done some experiments, and my first frustration went away really quick when I realized that prompt sucks. What is AIPRM is a very simple question, but it's not a good prompt. And that's what AIPRM is about. And let me show you what is possible with the right prompt. This is the AIPRM prompt better browsing. When you look at that, did execute the right search. It then processed that reading from the AIPRM website. I clicked on Chrome Store. It searched for AIPRM reviews on Product Hunt. It found a usage guide. It looked at tutorials on YouTube. And guess what? This is a tutorial that I recorded. Now that makes sense, doesn't it? And so here we got actually 5 different domains, 6 sources, and AIPRM is known as an AI prompt manager. Yeah, that's not the official abbreviation, but you can name it like that. It gives you access. It's a popular extension with over 1.3 million users, which I find very interesting. It got from the Chrome Store, our website on AIPRM.com, where it has the actual basic information. Was not updated for weeks, and I'm sorry about that, because we're building a new website. But what we see here is that it took a different source for the more accurate example, explaining AIPRM a lot better. Essentially acts as a fine tuner for ChatGPT. I don't know where that is from, but I think it's brilliant. It is a fine tuning tool, a productivity tool, and it even talks about a Product Hunt reviews. So it's all there. So that is what I expected out of the box from the web browsing model. So how does that work? What's the AIPRM prompt better browsing? It's one of those prompts not yet published to the AIPRM verified prompts, but you see how it works. You get a prompt to yourself if you actually enable that web browsing model, because you need to enable this, otherwise it won't work. And you can pick the number of sources it should use. 5 sources is the minimum you want for good research, right? And then we found that spammy domain, and nothing easier than blacklisting that domain. And then you say, what is AIPRM? Your simple human question makes a lot of sense, but you need to give ChatGPT instructions with that prompt template of what to do. And here we go. And that's how it works. For you, from a user perspective, it looks the same, but underneath it does a lot more. And like all the prompt templates in AIPRM, it instructs ChatGPT better of what is expected, of what good research is, of how many sources it should use and which sources it should not use. And that prompt template is a very nice example of our drop-down prompt feature, the way you saw we picked the yes-no enabling or the number of sources, right? So it's still slow, and you see it picks a different source here, but you get the idea. This is what we want in web browsing with ChatGPT. And again, this is totally different from the live URL crawling feature that we have. I hope this was useful, and I hope to see you try the Browse Better prompt very soon. Thank you and enjoy.